Hey guys, welcome back to another new video, Dereck Reacts, back at it again for the first time ever on Dereck Reacts, 1927 with If I Could. Taking it back to 1988, guys, and you can thank a Patreon subscriber for recommending me this one, and I can't wait to get my hands on this. Let's get right to it. Before we get into the video, please take a moment, comment, like, and subscribe. Makes videos like these all the more possible. And also join Patreon today. If you do, you're supporting the channel, guys. Yes, and it's greatly appreciated. Never goes unnoticed. Check out my store. I have a lot of custom tees, a lot of cool stuff. If you see something you like, it is yours, friends. It is yours. It's stuff I designed myself and custom made. Put a lot of love into it. Let's check it out. Follow and subscribe on Instagram, Facebook, and Spotify, where all my Dereck React hits make the cut. All right, guys, without further ado, let's go. Oh, it's a ballad, guys, I think. If I could write, I'd write a book for you. A tale of hidden treasures with an IOU. And a million words wouldn't say a thing that won't be said in three words, where love's the central theme. If I could do anything at all, I'd do it for you. What do you guys think of this song so far? It's an interesting song, right? It's one of those 80s kind of like rock ballads of its time. Nothing really special though. I don't know. I mean, I'm kind of like, it just seems like it's just like a very just a typical regular type of song, you know, nothing that's surprising or nothing too special. Nothing too special. Is that what he says? Something, he says something special. The lyrics are okay. You know, it's like a love song, right? Love song. And he talks about his insecurities. He's saying that he wished he could do more for his significant other and so forth. And we kind of see them kind of like there, like they're like standing, and it cuts off, and then it comes back to the band. Let's continue, guys. Let's see what they got here. What else they got left? They got the guitars. They got some keyboard arrangements and some drums. Let's continue. on keyboards. Come on, nuts. Interesting. It's kind of like a small little town. So yeah, guys, the stuff I said during my intermittent break there, it stands true to that, even all the way through. It peaked number 4 on the ARIA singles chart, and it was certified gold. It was nominated for the highest-selling single of the ARIA Music Awards in 1989, but lost to I Should Be Lucky by Kylie Minogue. We did that one. That was fun. Australia 4. This is an Australian band, guys. And you guys have a lot of Australian talent out there. I noticed a lot of good groups and stuff like that. These guys are not bad. It's just there's just nothing to be wowed about, you know. And, you know, it's okay. You know, it's nothing crazy. Interesting band, rock pop band, 1927. I wonder what's the significance behind that. But interesting, guys. Let me know what you think about this one down below. I'm curious to know what you guys have to say. Until next time, for more videos like these, guys, take care. Hey, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you'd like to see more videos like these, be sure to check this one out. And also, take a moment to comment, like, and smash the subscribe button. Stay on all the latest reaction videos. All right, guys. Take care. Love you guys. Peace.